Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up and left the house and went off to a solitary place where he prayed. Our counselor, Mark 1 and 35. Good morning, radio family. Thank you for worshiping with AM Devotion. This is your kingdom servant, Pastor Kay Hadley, featuring meditation, affirmation, prayer, and biblical insight. This devotional ministry serves as a spiritual platform, enhancing our personal relationship with Jesus Christ. This is another resource in the kingdom of God for us to increase and grow, producing the fruits of the Spirit, and to acknowledge daily that all of our life is worship. For those who do not know the Lord, you are invited to pray the prayer of salvation along with me following the morning devotion. Radio family, let's rise together, giving our first offering of the day to God the Father, Jesus Christ our Savior, and yielding to the breath of God, the Holy Spirit, who is our advocate and our helper. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us with another day and embracing us with your Spirit, your love, your grace, mercy, power, and authority today. Lord, we love you. We honor you and we adore you. Amen. Amen. And so be it. Now go ahead and grab that cup of coffee or tea and position yourself in your quiet place wherever you are, creating your sanctuary, y'all, along with your Bible, your journal, and your pen. Now release all negativity and the weights of sin. According to our counselor, Hebrews 12, 1 and 2. Here is Brother Doug Williams telling us to let it go.
If you want your joy back,
let it go.
If you want your peace,
let it go.
If you want to be happy,
let it go.
Then you got to let it go.
If you want to be free,
let it go.
Want to sleep at night,
let it go.
Amen. Amen. And so be it.
Good morning, Poppy. Morning prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. And let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer, our counselors, Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 through 13, Psalms 19 and 14.
You gave us your love. Now I say
Morning affirmation. Increase your capacity to receive. Our counselor, John 1:16, the New Living Translation says, "We have all benefited from the rich blessings he brought to us. One gracious blessing after another." I affirm God does not need to increase his capacity to give to you, but you need to increase your capacity to receive from him. I affirm God's resources are never decreased, never diminished, or depleted. The blessings that God sends to you are not measured out by allotment. God doesn't say, "Your blessing allotment for this month is 100. Since I've already given you or sent you 99 blessings this week, you only have one blessing left for the entire month." No. I affirm that your desire before the Lord should be that he enlarge you, that he grow your faith, and make your vessel deeper, taller, wider, so that you can move from fullness to greater fullness, from fruit to much fruit, and from streams of love to rivers of love. Amen. Amen. And so be it. You are listening to AM Devotion with Pastor Kay Hadley on Cruisin 92.1 FM, WVLT. AM Devoters, welcome to our new series entitled, Speak to the Rock. Our counselor, Proverbs 18 and 21 says, "Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof." You know, our world today is currently in a challenging season. It's impacting our spiritual, mental, and physical wellness. So it's easy to navigate our thoughts on the negative. Every day we're hearing about many people that are losing their jobs, many people being impacted and infected by COVID-19. There's no source of income coming in for many folks. Financial destructions, there's hopelessness, there's homelessness, there's desperation, and the spirit of fear and anger and hatred and division is running rampantly throughout the land. And you might be even saying to yourself, things look pretty bleak to me. I don't see things changing anytime soon. In fact, it looks humanly impossible for things to change. But the fact of the matter is, the words that you speak determines your destiny. The words we speak is a matter of life and death, the Bible says. We can experience blessings in our life by the words that we speak, but also we can also experience destruction in our lives when we speak words that cause destruction. Listen up, we can control our whole life if we can control our tongue. Let me say that one more time. We can control our whole life if we control our tongue. It's like a rudder. It's a flat piece of wood which can steer a big ship, right? A rudder steers a ship by generating areas of high and low pressure. So likewise, our words can determine the direction of our lives, generating positive or negative manifestations or results. In addition, the Bible also tells us in Matthew 12:36, the NIV version says, "But I tell you that everyone will have to give an account on the day of judgment for every empty word they have spoken." Depending on what Bible version you're reading, the word empty reflects careless, thoughtless, worthless words. Our counselor, James 3:6, says, "The tongue also is a fire, a world of wickedness among the parts of the body. It pollutes the whole person and sets the course of his life on fire and is itself set on fire by hell." So we learn in the text that we have to give an account before God on the day of judgment for every careless word that we speak. Therefore, we must be very careful over every word that we speak, right? We must have a good heart and speak good words out of the overflow of the good treasure of our heart. Now, I want you to write this in your journal. It matters what I say. It matters what I speak. What's in my heart? Our hearts must be filled with the Word of God. There is enormous power in the Word of God, and God created the universe by the words he spoke. When we speak the Word of God, the power of God will be released to accomplish the purpose for which it is sent. The Word of God gives us faith and knowledge for salvation. We must continually hear the Word of God in order to fill our hearts with faith. We must not listen to the words of fear and unbelief. Let's check out our counselor, Genesis chapter 1. Beginning at the third verse. And God said, let there be light, and there was light. So what's happening here, radio family? God spoke it, and it manifested. Verse 6 says, and God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. And of course, it was so. Verse 9 said, and God said, let the waters under the heaven be gathered together unto one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. Verse 11 said, and God said, let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after its kind, whose seed in itself upon the earth. And it was so. Verse 14 says, and God said, let the lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and for years, and let them be for lights in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth. And it was so. The 20th verse said, and God said, let the waters bring forth abundantly the moving creature that hath life, and fowl that it may fly above the earth in the open firmament of the heaven. And of course, it was so. Verse 24 said, and God said, let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, his cattle, creeping thing, and beast of the earth after his kind. And it was so. Verse 26 says, and God said, let us make man in our image after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Let's pause for a second, and in your journal, I want you to write the word dominion. Dominion means authority. So I'm going to go back to that passage. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have authority over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, over the cattle, and over all the earth. Did he say half the earth, a part of the earth, a portion of the earth? No, the word of God said over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. In your journals, next to dominion and authority, answer this question. Is there evidence of godly authority in your life? God already spoke it, but are you exercising your godly authority? Question mark. Let's go back to the text, Genesis chapter 1, beginning at the 27th verse. So God created man in his image. In the image of God created he him, male and female created he them. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, replenish the earth and subdue it, and have dominion. There's their word dominion again, which is authority over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. The 29th verse said, and God said, he's speaking again, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in which is the fruit of a tree yielding seed, to you it shall be for meat, and to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth, wherein it is there is life, I have given every green herb for meat. And it was so. And the 31st verse said, and God saw everything that he made, and behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day. Now that you know God spoke, giving you dominion and the authority to rule over all things, you now know that you can rule over what you speak. Amen. I said earlier, we can control our whole life when we can control our tongue. In your journals, I want you to write down, I am in control. Right below, I am in control, I want you to write transformation statement. And your transformation statement is, I can control my whole life because I can control my tongue. When the tongue is consecrated and when it is guided and controlled by a heart full of the Holy Ghost, it becomes a mighty power to destroy the works of the devil. Your words determine your destiny. The Word of God has creative power. We must boldly speak the promises of God by faith. Positive words bring health and happiness. And parents, God has given you the authority, the dominion to bless or curse your children. When you are speaking grace, our words can lead seekers to Christ to find eternal life. Powerful words of comforting and encouraging words, they take the place of mocking words, encouraging those that are sorrowing. Powerful words of comfort and encouragement brings life to the soul. My friends, kind words, they take the place of cruel words. And every kind word that is spoken makes this world more like heaven. For where slander begets hate and kindness begets love, and that word begets means it procreates, it produces, it births. So what we speak makes a difference. True words go forth to do battle against the falsehoods, right, of which the earth is full of. Every true word that is spoken binds human society more closely together and makes the burden of life easier to bear. When you speak to the rock, you are speaking to the Lord, and you are speaking the word of God back to him. The words you speak, they plant seeds that you can't see, but they will manifest. This means that your words have power to shape everything in your life. Radio family, this week I want you to meditate on Genesis chapter 1. I also want you to recite every day. I want you to speak your transformation statement, which says, I can control my whole life because I can control my tongue. Tune in for more next week. My friend, if you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior today, and you are ready to surrender your all to God, please pray this prayer of salvation along with me. God, for too long, I've kept you out of my life, but I will no longer close the door of my heart. According to Romans 10 and 9, today I acknowledge and confess with my mouth and believe with the sincerity of my heart that you are Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who died for my sins and rose from the dead to present me with the gift of salvation right now. Come into my heart and live in me forever as my Savior and Lord. Amen, amen, and so be it. Welcome, brother, welcome, sister, into the multi-ethnic, multi-generational kingdom of God. You have a new identity in Christ. The angels are rejoicing in heaven.
I can only imagine when all I would do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine.
Pastor Kay here. Thank you for tuning into our fourth quarter series entitled Speak to the Rock. The Rock is Jesus Christ, our Lord. Our counselor, Proverbs 18 and 21 says, "Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof." This means, radio family, what you speak becomes your reality. Our counselor, Matthew 12 and 37 says, "For by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned." Come on, radio family, speak to the rock. Our counselor, Deuteronomy 32, 3 and 4 says, "I will proclaim the name of the Lord. Oh, praise the greatness of our God. He is the rock. His works are perfect, and all of his ways are just. A faithful God who does no wrong, upright, and just is he." My prayer is that you'll be spiritually informed and empowered through each devotional encounter with God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Yes, it's time to level up and get ready for more. And help me spread the word and connect others to this radio ministry series. Amen. Amen. And so be it. Hashtag power of your tongue. Hashtag declare God's word. Hashtag speak to the rock. Radio family, for a list of today's scriptural references, or to share how AM devotion is blessing you, or to inquire about sponsorship opportunities, contact Pastor Kay Hadley at amdevotionradio@gmail.com. That's amdevotionradio@gmail.com. Looking forward to hearing from you. And don't forget to check out our YouTube channel and subscribe to AM Devotion Radio Ministry. Up next is Found Joy in Jesus Ministry with Evangelist Tracy Suggs, bringing you the best in old school gospel. So keep it locked on Cruisin 92.1 FM. Until we devote again, have a lovely day.